Hello everyone, Christian from Critical Design here today to talk about Ivanti Application Control User Privileges. Application Control is a part of the User Workspace Manager or UWM suite. Application Control as a whole has a few different parts. We have Application Whitelisting, Application Network Access Control, and the part we will be talking about today, User Privilege Management. Application Control is a great tool for removing admin rights without stopping their ability to run what is required for productivity. A few business cases for user privileges is users with admin rights that we would like to remove. Admins with too many rights, maybe they abuse their admin credentials that we can restrict them. Applications that need admin rights to run. These are the one or two applications in your enterprise that you need to give your end users full admin rights to run. Applications that cannot be patched without admin rights. Application Control is great for only elevating applications that absolutely need it. It injects the administrator token into the process rather than giving it to the user. Along with elevating applications, we can restrict admins from using their rights to stop items such as antivirus services and in any other critical functions to maintain security in our environment. A great example for elevating rights is installing an approved application. We can use Application Control to elevate control panel items as well. We can give permissions to, say, change the date and time of a user's laptop if they travel, while still requiring admin rights to run all of the functions of the control panel. Along with elevating applications and control panel items, Application Control allows us to elevate or restrict rights to certain services. If your enterprise has issues with print drivers, we can elevate the permissions for just the print spooler to allow the users to restart the service. On the other side, we can restrict administrators' permissions and revoke the ability to stop AV solution services. Application Control allows us to prevent administrators from terminating process, like we talked about in the last slide. You can see here is an example of restricting the ability to terminate the Application Control agent process. Finally, a tool to go from full admin rights for end users to just a subset of allowed items, we have self-elevation. And self-elevation allows users to get admin privileges when requiring them to run an application. This allows administrators to remove admin rights from the environment, but still allows users the ability to elevate their privileges for certain apps if they need to. It also gives us granularity to only allow elevations of certain file extensions, such as PS1s, to only run with a certain application, such as PowerShell. Next, we will hop into a demo. Okay, now we're over here on our Windows 10 machine. We have an end user that is trying to install an approved application, Notepad++, onto their endpoint. Without admin rights, this is going to be an issue. If we try to run this installer here, we see we get a UAC prompt. They would need admin rights to install Notepad++. With Application Control, we can come into the console, come to User Privileges under Everyone, so we're giving everyone the ability to install the Notepad++. We can add a file rule and browse to the location. Take off this path. And then we can also attach metadata to this, so the vendor, for example. So it has to have the vendor of Notepad++ and be named this file extension to be able to be installed. So we can add that here, save this off. And now when we try to run Notepad installer, we can see we're able to go through and actually install it. And if we let it run, we can see that it actually launches as well. The next part we talked about in our slideshow was control panel items. So if we come over here, we try to launch the control panel. And we go into date and time. And we need to change the date and time because we went to a different time zone. We can see we get a UAC prompt is here as well. Coming back into our configuration of Application Control, we can go to the Components tab of User Privileges and add a component, date and time. Save this back to our endpoint. And now when we try to change the date and time, we're able to change it to whatever we need. The next part was services. Say your enterprise has a universal print driver that's crashing frequently. And the users, since they don't have admin rights, can't manage it. We can see we have no functions here. If we come into application control, go to system controls and add a service control item. Scroll down to print spooler. And make this an elevation instead of a restrict. Minimize this. And now refresh this. We can see that we're able to manage the print spooler. Now we can stop and restart it while services such as power we're still unable to manage. The final part I would like to talk about is self-elevation. And self-elevation can be enabled here. We can set it for only specific regions or specific applications for elevation. And then we also have options here to display a message box to require a reason for the elevation. So we can audit what they're elevating and why they're elevating to add it to our list if it is approved. So now if we save this, come back over here, and for my example, I'll run PuTTY. So we run this with administrative privileges audited. We're going to get a pop-up saying, give us a reason why you're elevating it. We could say, connecting to remote server. Continue. And we can see the PuTTY launches. Now coming down here, if we open up the task manager and go to the details tab, scroll down to PuTTY, we can see PuTTY is running as the user, but it is elevated. So that's that injecting the admin token into the process rather than giving it to the user. That concludes our demo for today, and I hope this was helpful. Thank you.